There are certain rights which are created after marriage, one of which is called as conjugal rights, which means a right of the husband or the wife to the society of the other spouse. The law recognizes these rights both in personal laws dealing with marriage, divorce, etc., and in criminal law requiring payment of maintenance and alimony to a spouse. Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Priya Sipaha, and in this video we are going to discuss Section 9 of the Hindu Marriage Act, that is restitution of conjugal rights. In order to maintain the permanency of marriage, law provides for the provision of restitution of conjugal rights in the event of one party withdrawing from the society of the other and without any reasonable cause. The law seeks to maintain a stability of marital relationships and favors all attempts in order to prevent the breakdown of marriage. The restitution of conjugal right has been explained under Section 9 of the Hindu Marriage Act 1955. It states that whether the husband or the wife has, without reasonable excuse, withdraw from the society of the other, the aggrieved party may apply by petition to the district court for restitution of conjugal rights, and the court, on being satisfied of the truth of the statement made in such petition, and there is no legal ground why the application should not grant it, may decree restitution of conjugal rights accordingly. So the essential provision of this section are: one party has withdrawn from the society of the other, that means any of the party has withdrawn to live with another one. Second important point is, such withdrawal is without any reasonable reason. Here it is necessary to understand the meaning of reasonable reason. And the third one is, the aggrieved party applies for the restitution of conjugal rights. The basic object of decree of restitution of conjugal rights is to bring about cohabitation between the parties so that they can live together. It does not aim to force a person to sexual relationship. Further, the decree is granted if the reason for withdrawal is not reasonable. If the court finds that the petitioner is guilty, then the decree of restitution of conjugal rights is not granted. Moreover, if after the passing of the decree, the parties do not cohabit continuously for 1 year, then it becomes a ground for dissolution of marriage under Section 13. Now let's discuss reasonable grounds for withdrawal. The first one is, if there exists a ground on which the respondent can claim any matrimonial relief. The second one is, if the petitioner is guilty of any matrimonial misconduct. And third one is, if the petitioner is guilty of such act, omission or conduct which make it impossible for the respondent to live with him. For example, husband's neglect of his wife or the constant demand of dowry is reasonable ground for the wife to stay at parents' place. Now, the burden of proof. The initial burden of proof that the respondent has withdrawn from the society of the petitioner is on the petitioner. Once that burden is discharged, it is for the respondent to prove that there exists a reasonable excuse for the withdrawal. There is always a question of constitutional validity of Section 9. So let's discuss that. It has been contended in many cases that Section 9 of the Hindu Marriage Act is violative of right to privacy under Article 21. In many cases, the wife has stated that the section is misused by husband to force the wife into living with them against her wish. The earliest instance was the case of T. Sarita versus Venkat Subba before the Andhra Pradesh High Court in 1983. It was argued before the court that the provision was against the individual's fundamental right to liberty, privacy and dignity guaranteed by Article 21 of the Constitution. Further, it was argued that by virtue of being available to both husband and wives who are inherently in unequal positions, the provision was violative of the right to equality by violating the rule of equal protection of laws. The court agreed with these arguments and held that, in effect, the decree compelled an unwilling wife to have sexual intercourse with her husband, thereby violating her bodily autonomy. Thereby, the court struck down Section 9 of Hindu Marriage Act, declaring it to be violative of Article 14 and Article 21 of the Constitution. Subsequently, less than a year later, This question was put forth before the High Court of Delhi in the case of Harvinder Kaur versus Harminder Singh, which descended the judgment of Andhra Pradesh High Court. Ultimately, the Supreme Court, in the judgment of Saroj Rani versus Sudarshan Kumar Chadha, resolved the conflict between the two judgments by upholding the views put forth by the Delhi High Court, stating that the objective of the decree was not only an inducement of the spouses to live together, and that it did not force an unwilling wife to engage in sexual relations with the husband. The aim was only to bring about cohabitation between spouses, and therefore it was only focused on consortium. Law seeks to provide stability of marriage. It does not force a person into unwanted relations. The decree is passed only when there is an unreasonable withdrawal of society. However, it may be misused by husbands or wives into coercing their unwilling partners into cohabitation. Therefore, it is a duty of the court to inquire judiciously and order accordingly. That's all about the restitution of conjugal rights. I hope you liked the video, and if you like it, do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe my channel. And please do comment so that I get motivated and answer and make more and more video about whatever questions and queries asked by you and demanded by you. Thank you for watching. See you soon. Bye-bye.